Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolotech, and today Apple released iOS 15.6 Beta 4. This is currently available to developers, and hopefully by the time you're watching this video, it will be out to public beta testers as well. If not today, usually the following day. Now this came in at 606.4 megabytes, that's on the iPhone 12 Pro, and was between 500 and 600 megabytes on the other devices here as well. Along with this, Apple also released iPadOS 15.6 Beta 4, watchOS 8.7 Beta 4, tvOS 15.6 Beta 4, macOS 12.5 Beta 4, and HomePodOS 15.6 Beta 4. Now let's take a look at the build number and talk about what's new. So we'll go to Settings, then General, then About. As you can see, the build number is 19G5056C. At this point, I thought we'd have an A at the end, which means maybe we could have a Beta 5, or we could have a release candidate next. We'll talk more about that a little bit later. Now this particular update does have a modem update, at least on the iPhone 12 Pro, where we went from version 2.70.00 to 2.70.01. So that should help with connectivity, although it is much better than iOS 15.5 already. Now, as far as new features and changes, first, there was a new promotional update or email sent out to those who create podcasts, and it says create social posts as unique as your show and gives more information about this. This was sent out to creators today if they have a podcast. Also, that new MacBook Air should be available as soon as next month. So hopefully we'll see that very soon. And you can see that on Apple's website. Configure it now if you're looking for that. So we'll go over to apple.com. And you can see the MacBook Air here with different pricing and more. It's still only available in July. Also, I did mention in other videos, but wanted to share here since this is updated even if you're not running the betas. If you go to Settings and then under Settings, tap on your name and then Subscriptions, Apple has updated the subscriptions interface with more information, separated it a little bit more easily. And then if you go into a subscription, it looks a little different and has an easy cancel subscription button. So they've updated this on iOS 15.5 all the way to iOS 16 betas. Now there are new features and changes in Beta 4. One of those has to do with Safari. If you go into your settings, scroll down to Safari. Under Safari, scroll to the bottom. If you scroll down to where you can clear history and website data, tap on that, clear the history and data, it will now ask you if you want to close tabs. It says, do you also want to close open tabs? This will not affect tabs in your tabs group. You can keep the tabs or close the tabs. It's just a small change, but something that they've updated. Also, we'll keep that for now. And if we go back up into our communication safety settings, this is for a child. It's disabled by default, but I talked about it before. But if you go into your screen time and tap on one of your children, and under that child, if they're young enough, you'll have the option for communication safety. Tap on communication safety, and there's a new option for improve communication safety. You can turn this on or leave it off as it is by default. And it says help Apple improve communication safety by sending analytics and usage data. Analytics and data are aggregated in a form that is not personal identifiable. And it says no message or media are shared with Apple. And then there's more information about it. So you have the option, and I think there might be a typo in there, is not personal identifiable. Maybe personally it should say, but again, it is a beta, and this particular update just has this option now. So that's something new within this update. Also in your settings, if you go under accessibility, under voiceover and Braille, there's some new Braille options if you have a compatible device. I don't have a compatible device, as you can see here, but if you do, there'll be some new options for different panning keys, thumb keys, and more, such as C2 and C3 options. So these are things that are added within the code that you can't see directly, but is there. There's also additional updates within the code, just like there has been in previous betas, and there's updates to the health sharing code. So if you're using health and you're sharing health, there's additional options there as well. Also within the home app, if maybe you're sharing a home with someone and then someone sends you an invite that you don't recognize, they maybe invite you to control a lock on their home and you don't recognize it, you'll now have the option to report that invite as junk, ignore it, or cancel it. Now I don't have anyone that can actually share that invite with me, so I can try that out. That's not in my contacts list, but if you do see that, there should be an option here within the home app. Also, under software updates, there's some code changes as well. You'll see there's an update available if you have one and you're on the betas. So not a huge change, but some small changes within the home app. Within the wallet app, there's some code changes as well. If maybe you're adding a balance to your device, sometimes you could have an error. And if you do have an error, it will give you a message saying that an update is in progress. So that's only replicatable if you have that error, but that's in the code itself. Also, there's wording changes when you're setting up an iPhone with an iTunes and podcast account. So that's when you're actually setting up your phone and setting up those accounts. Some of the wording will be slightly different, not a whole lot of changes. So with iOS 15.6, it's mostly small changes, code updates, and security updates. Once it's released, we'll know what those are. As far as known and resolved issues, within Apple's notes, there are no known and resolved issues. You can see in the feedback app, here are all of the issues or notes for beta 4, but there are two known issues. One of them says the iOS device that initiates pairing needs to be logged into the same iCloud account as the home hub. Only the owner of a home, not an invited user, can pair Matter accessories. Also, there's a known issue that's been there for a while with Xcode 13.4, where it's unable to prepare 15.6 beta devices for development. They tell you to use Xcode 13.3.1. So some very small known issues. However, we've talked about in the past storage issues. And if we go into our settings and go to storage, I did notice that it loads very quickly now, or at least it did for me. So we'll see if it actually loads quickly this time, and it did load quickly. So going into that takes just a moment, and then you can see your iOS storage and then system data. Sometimes this can take a moment to fill, but it does not seem to be taking up a huge amount of storage. So we'll give it just a moment here. System data completed at 6.18 gigabytes, and this can vary between 0 and 20 gigabytes. It's at the bottom for a reason, as it typically manages itself. However, I'd love to hear from you if it's using a ton of data, as it seems to be resolved for the majority of users. If it is presenting a problem, make sure to report that in the feedback app. Now, as far as the iPhone overheating or getting too hot, most people report with iOS 15.6 with earlier betas that it's nice and cool. And this time around, it hasn't even gotten warm today. Even running benchmarks, it was barely warm. So that's a good sign. It seems to be staying nice and cool. And even with the iPhone 12 Pro models, it was an issue. So it seems to be much cooler than it was before. And that's great now that we're getting into summer and it's even hotter outside. However, if you have a case sealing everything, it definitely could be quite warm. Now, as far as the next releases, we can expect iOS 15.6 either beta 5 or release candidate as soon as next week. Typically this late in updates, we'll have them week to week. It's very rare not to. And then we could have a release candidate next week with a final release, maybe in the week of July 10th. If we don't have it, then we could have it pushed out a week with beta 5, then the release candidate, then the final release. Now, next week, we could possibly expect iOS 16 public beta and then beta 3 releasing as well to developers. Usually, Apple will push out the public beta and then beta 3 will come within the next few days to the following week. We should see that, of course, with additional updates and changes, and I'll keep you informed of that as well. And then, of course, we'll have iOS 15 and iOS 16 betas, usually till the end of August with iOS 15, and then September, usually around mid-September, we'll have the release of iOS 16 to the public. So that's what you can expect, along with a release of iOS 4 or iPhone 14 and 14 Pro, Pro Max, and iPhone 14 Max. All of those things we can expect in mid-September. And of course, we'll have security updates with this, and we'll find out what those are when it releases to the public with iOS 15.6. Now, as far as if you should install iOS 15.6 beta 4, at this point, if you're running the betas, definitely install it. However, if you're running maybe iOS 15.5 and having major issues, iOS 15.6 does seem to be fairly stable. However, it is a beta, so make sure you have a backup and a way to roll back your phone if you need to, as you'll need a computer to do that if you're having issues. But most people that switch to iOS 15.6 have better battery life and in general have just a better experience. If we go into settings, of course, I haven't been using this as my main device, but battery health on this device is 100%. Of course, it wasn't my main phone at all, really. Usually I use the Max model. And typical battery life for this, you'll see today I've just been running a little bit for an hour and 39 minutes, and we're at 25% usage. So it's pretty good so far, especially since I just installed a beta, and usually it will get you through a day without a problem. Most people report on beta 3, the last version, that they were getting through a day on previous devices, whether that be an iPhone 7, 8, or 11. Most people were having great battery life with it. As far as overall performance, it does seem to be performing well. I did run Minecraft here just to try it out, see how quickly it loaded, and you'll see we're back in and resumed, and it's nice and fast. Frame rates are great. Of course, if you have a ProMotion display, it may be a little bit different for you, and you can see it's nice and fast in general. Frame rates are great, and of course, I'm not playing this very well, but you'll see it's super smooth, and it loaded very, very fast, whether that's on this device or an older device. Now, I did run benchmarks with Geekbench 5, and if we go into that, it's a little bit lower than before, with single core at 1,579 and multi-core at 3,994. If we take a look at the history, again, like I said, it's a little bit lower, and typically after it's done processing in the background, these numbers will bump up and usually be a little bit better or about the same. So they're within 20 to 30. That's not really a big deal. Typically, that means we'll have pretty good performance overall. The multi-core is a little bit lower, but again, it's processing things in the background with the latest update. So I'll be sure to run those a little bit later, and we'll have a follow-up on the weekend where we talk about that a little bit more. And so that's everything in iOS 15.6 Beta 4. Now, if you found anything, I'd love to hear from you in the comments below. And of course, if you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. If you haven't subscribed already, though, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.